Hey everybody, this is Ann Clemmer. I am so happy to be here with you. It is finally Friday. That means we're going to make something fast and fabulous. You know, we're going to have a great time and I'm so glad you're here. Hey, let's get started. Stamper, come. Yeah, hey, almost ready. You know, if I was ready, you just wouldn't know. Yeah, you could think you were in the wrong place. But I have to tell you, we have a dog here that is very, I hate to disturb him because here he is. I'll show you the picture. If you've been here before, and if you haven't, hey, introduce yourself. We'd love to have you. Yeah, we're glad you're here. But anyway, usually I have a dog shot. Well, right now, you know, you can't see that dog shot because I've turned the bed up on its end. See, there's my foot, right? Which reminds me, go red for women. I've been wearing red a lot this week and I have not said anything about it. So anyway, what happened was I needed to get around his bed and he wasn't in it. So I turned it on and said, well, that is what is actually happening right now. He's there. You saw the top of the bed. See, oh golly, it just reminded me I'm on. Imagine that. What would I have done? Anyway, there's the top of the bed here's the dog. So yeah, there he is. That's what it looks like. So when he moves, well, maybe I'll move and maybe I won't. Yeah. So what you been doing since Wednesday? Oh, all my Facebook peeps are in here. Let's see if we've just got to make sure that YouTube is flying fast. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Oh. Oh, yeah. Got my hair did yesterday. It's just a little bit shorter, not much. You know what it's like breaking in a new hairdresser? It's always fun. And she's really, really nice and younger than me. Yeah. Yeah, even doctors are younger than me now. Hey, from Houston. And here, Kali, I have a couple Texans in here. Oh boy. So let's take a little pause for that. Yes, you know, heart disease kills more women than a lot of other things. And they have, you know, Go Red for Women Month. And we're, you know, it's not hard for me to wear red. Come on. I do have more than one of these. Anyway, but I do have my red shoes on. And so remember, hey, let's all go out for a walk this afternoon. When we're done, we're going to shut down. And before we go and make our cards, we're going to go take a walk. Yeah. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Did I put a funny in here today? Let me see. I don't think I did. Oh, yeah, I did, but you'll have to wait. Oh, wow. See, look, isn't this good? Kathy's up there, you know, in Nevada, and there you go. Yeah, she's up there in Nevada, and, well, I'm used to not seeing my family for, you know, sometimes a year or two, but what if we didn't have phones? What if we didn't have FaceTime? Well, I don't have FaceTime, but you know, I rigged up FaceTime before FaceTime was a thing. Yeah. It was so funny. We went and, I used GoToWebinar and, which is kind, it can be like Zoom anyway. And I sent on Christmas, we sent my brother-in-law the link. So what did they do? They all sat on the couch and they're like, way back there. And here we are on a big screen TV. So for them, we're like this, right? And then, but we're looking at them and they're like, little people. Yeah, better feed the dogs first. Yep. Okay. So we're going to do the same layout twice. And, you know, this is a public service reminder here. There's a public service reminder. This ends. That's Sunday. Don't let that get away from you. There's lots of good stuff in here. As I just looked, there's nothing that they're out of yet. You know, they're not going to make more. Like, they're not going to say, wow, we sold five more Oso Hombre papers than we thought, you know, and they're not going to make five more for you. We're going to work with this today. There's lots of lovely stuff. We got butterflies coming out next month, but that's not going to get you free stamps this month. So I got this card. I did everything except for I did not cut these out. So I'll get my little mini out here. This little mini is a good thing to have. It's a good thing to have. But and I was so happy that Janet, who has got a different little mini, right? She didn't have a full size one. She was going to buy the mini. And I went, no, you need to buy the big one. She thought they were $160. How about that? But they are $120. And if you don't have a big cut and emboss type machine, then you really want to make sure you do that, because then all of the dies work like this. See, I got to cut it in half in order to do this. So as you can see, I'm going to make two sympathy cards. This is like a luxury thing, kind of like that purse I just bought me. Yeah, Karen Thomas, you have started me on a path to brokenness. Yeah, it's all her fault. She took me into a purse shop one time. You think that you don't have, okay, we think that we don't have effects on people, right? But I saw a purse in this purse shop and I went, wow, that would fit me. And I almost bought it, right? And then I went, no, I'm not going to pay that. No. Well, fast forward a few years. Yeah, in a perfect world, that would be just perfect. But it's done. So then I ordered one and then I ordered a second one. Look at, it'd be nice if I put that right side up. This moves around because I'm on like a grid pad, and I'm sorry that's out of, I'd like it to go in and focus over here. There you go. But it's still not focusing there. So we pretend that's straight. And if it's not, well, there's a reason I don't always finish the card, because maybe it's not quite straight and you don't notice it, but if I put the card together, that exact part of my personality would come out. It does show its ugly head every now and then. Yeah, well, I figure if I get it, I got a big one. And then last night I ordered a small one in my favorite color. And then I tried to call him like 6 hours later and say, can I change that and get like a more expensive one? And, you'd think that they'd do it. And the guy said, no, too bad, so sad. You ordered this yesterday. I'm like, well, it was only 6 hours ago. Yeah, but you know what? Stampin' Up! Does that too. So, okay. Okay, time to turn the fan on. Yay. That fan, in order for me to get it low enough to where it doesn't come across on the mic, or like a certain frequency so you don't hear it, I have to make it go faster than I want. I only want it to move the air, Oh, golly. Yeah, we're getting our second shots on next week. And you're going to love this. I purposely put my shot an hour after the show's over so that I wouldn't miss being with you next Wednesday. Yeah, but next Friday might be kind of hard. Hey, pray for Barbara. Barbara's down there in Texas right now looking at houses. Yeah. Or maybe, I don't know how long for. So, hey, how about let's have a good shot for the day. Life is always now. Thank you, Tennessee. I don't know what's on the other side. Don't be afraid to take a big step. You can't cross a chasm in two small jumps. That wouldn't be pretty. So somebody gave me this card, and I'm going to go and oh my goodness, be careful. I'm going to do a knockoff of what my friend did, and I'm going to use, this is really fairly simple. If I can just find the parts that's not it. Okay. This is one thing I wanted to show you, and I don't know if you can tell with the mic, but you know, sometimes I can feel the difference. This one's heavy. This one's not. But if you pick up a smaller one, sometimes it's hard to tell. This is the thicker, very vanilla, and this is the thinner, very vanilla. See if you can hear this. That's the thicker. And you see how the when you do them to, you know, shake them together, the thicker one has a lower sound. Was harder to tell that time. The things that you learn here. Now I ran two things through the embossing folder. So since I don't know like where that is right this second, I'm going to give you here's another. I hope you can read my read my writing. There they are. They were right underneath the stamp set. Those are things that are, you cannot order today, but you will be able to order them the week of this. So it's not on 329. It's not on 329. It's the week of 329. So I'm going to show the blending brushes today, but you can't order blending brushes today. But don't give up hope. They're coming. You know, does this help you so that you know things that aren't available? You know, let me know by in the chat. And for some reason, the people over in YouTube are very, 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 very quiet. Yeah, very quiet. Let me see if it works. Well, it'd help to have a keyboard. Like, I think I have to go and spell something out. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, they're just quiet today. That's okay. So does this help you, you know, to know these things? Because like pastel pearls, they went behind before. And the week of 3/8, they'll be available again. And then the seashells folder. You know, sometimes you wonder why I don't show you things, because if I know you can't order them, I mean, why make, you know, why cause angst, you know? Okay, so I ran this through the painted textures. You know, you gotta love this. I'm gonna try it a different way in a minute. And then, hold on here, I'm rubbing these around and it's this one. It's really worth it to have the thick basic white and the thick whisper, very vanilla, because they'll make your cards easier to stand up. Okay, hold on. Put this way. That means this one is, well, that's the plan. Marcy's got a question, and that's the plan. What stamp set are you talking about, and what punch? Are you talking about the strawberry punch? And the one that is free with a purchase? No, you can't get that next week. You can only get the celebration things. Like, I think this is what she's talking about. This right here. Right? The punch complements this. It doesn't go with this. I believe the punch fits these, but you can't, there you go. The punch fits these, I'm pretty sure. But this just, there is no strawberry on this, but the strawberry stamp set that's in the big, you know, the not so mini catalog, that will be available. Well, some people call this the strawberry set. You know, I mean, there's a strawberry in it, but yeah, it should be. That's the plan. You know, we make our own stamps, so we have more of a control on that. This is the smartest thing I've done. I have to tell you, just doing that. Now, I'm going to try something on Monday. I want to call it Maintenance Monday. We're going to go over how to re-ink a pad, other things, you know, just things to help things last longer. Yeah. Boy, that's just so smooth. That's just so smooth. But if you haven't, you know, hey, this is where you want to go if you need something. And if you need a number for something, you don't know what it is, just ask. And I'm sure one of my favorite people out there will give it to you. Yeah. So this, I got to tell you, was just a simple card. I've got this. I'm going to put this on here, right? And it's just a really simple. Hold on, folks. It's just a really simple sympathy card. Now, the question is, well, I already stamped this. Okay, I already stamped this in Pretty Peacock. And Pretty Peacock's going away. Yeah, that's one of the things I wanted to talk to you about. If you have not done this already, please do it. Now, I'm going to tell you honestly, do not, I'm not going to, you don't have to do anything I say. This is just my perception, but come on, you're here. So I'm going to tell you from 22, is it 22? Yeah, 22 years of experience. When it comes to the in colors, if you don't already have these ink pads, you're golden. Just wait for the next one and just get them when they first come out, right? So then you get a whole full 2 years while they're popular. If you have these colors, okay, so like, a purple posy doesn't come in an ink pad, but let's say you really like Seaside Spray and you don't use the ink pad so much, so you're not going to worry about the refill, but you want to have some of that cardstock, and you want to have the blends, right? And maybe you really like that sparkly ribbon that we used on Wednesday. Well, get those. Because they're going to be, I guarantee you, they're going to be on the retiring list. And so, yeah, you want to get them. Now, let's say you go terracotta tile, not my wheelhouse. So you don't have to go and stock up on that. But the ones that you really like, go and make sure that you have at least, if you already have the ink pad, make sure you have at least a refill. So you're going to be able to use it for 3-4 more years, buy one or two packs of cardstock and call it good. Now, you don't need to buy 6 packs of cardstock. I'm just going to tell you, because they're called in colors for a reason. It may come back. And if it does, that's because it's popular still. Yeah. You know, I mean, yeah. So does that make sense? I love it when I pull something out to go and use it with you. And then I'm going, where did I put that down? I know I put that down somewhere. So someone's probably texting me to tell me where it is. It's not like I have such a big spot here. We may be changing. Okay. So my idea was, and as soon as I put this on here, I'll put the second card together so you'll see what I'm talking about. Because I took it out of the drawer. Lovely, lovely, lovely. But you know what? This would work. This is, does it have a name? Fine art ribbon. Oh, good. You're not looking. This is the fine art ribbon. And the idea that I had, see, look at it. It's already sold out. I took it out. I put it down. And yeah. But But there's some pretty peacock ribbon that's just like this, and it's got pretty peacock. Tie this around here. There. And so I'm not going to put this one together, but I'll show you what this is. This would work too. I would just put a brown there. But we'll put the next one together so you'll see. And then you could color some dots in this. Isn't that funny? Does it, tell me that never happens to you. They won't be doing it this year. she wants to know when they're doing a revamp on inks. They're not doing it this year because they already released that designer series paper that they're giving to demonstrators who sign up before Sunday. They're going to get 200 sheets of designer series paper and all the colors except for the ones that are releasing in May. What stamp set are you talking about, Marcy? Don't know. So yeah, can you tell me where I put that down at? It's not like, I mean, I'm only like right here. I'm going, it's not there. So I'm going to put this off. I'm going to put this off to the side. We're going to do the plan B one because I came up with two. Now you notice that I am not scoring this one. That doesn't mean that I shouldn't. That just means that Anne's kind of lazy and I match these corners and then I finger press and I match those corners and I finger press. Just give it a little press because I think it's a little warbly there. Would scoring help? Yes. You know, that dog is still over there. That dog is still over there. Just like that. He has not moved. The embossing folder is called Painted Texture, and I believe it's on back order, but you can still order it. So it will come. I didn't look to see exactly when those were coming. Now, this is what I did, and we're going to do a test. Now, I'm going to tell you something. On this one, I made this layer 3/8 of an inch smaller. So if you want to have more of the background color to show, then make it 3/8 of an inch smaller. This one I did 1/4 inch, and you'll see where you don't really see very much of the blackberry, right? But let's go, and they're not available, but oh, these, they're so pretty. They're so pretty. That you want to wait until we get these the end of March. Well, what do you know? We were wondering where y'all were. We were wondering where Laura was, and they, yeah. That's okay. You haven't missed much, but the best is yet to come, Laura. So here we go. I swore I bought a new one of these. This doesn't look like a new one. This looks like an old one. I hope I didn't like get a new one and then. Okay, so I'm going to tap it on there. Tap, 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 tap. And if we don't like it, we'll just turn it over. Oh, she got it on TV, but she couldn't get it on her iPad. Okay. So I'm tapping it on here, and I'm going to tap off just a little bit, and then I'm going to start off the edge, and I'm going to go, yeah. I like it. I like it. I like it a lot. Tap, 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 tap. Now, I am not going to use it to go and put my powder on right now, okay? But you could do that. You could do that. And this is the one to use it with. And you notice I'm not even putting pressure on it. I'm just going bat, that, that, right? And then just tap it off a little bit. And like I said, start off the edge. What I really like about this one, you can really see where I've been. You know, where we've done them before with terracotta tile. And while you're doing it, you're like, oh, I don't see it. And then you put it up against white and you go, oh, wow. I just did a card. Nope, it's in the other room. For Master Stampers using the Oso Ombre paper. And yeah, I think I like this way better like that. Oh, can't chat on TV. Yes, see, this is why, you know, just remember, this is your Easter gift you want, right? To give you a hint, now I showed you, but this is, that's one of the butterflies. There's like a ton of butterflies in this thing that's coming out next month, but you can't go and okay, so you think that when you're looking at it like that, you're going, oh, I don't know how much color's on there. Yes, you do. I mean, look at the difference. Look at the difference. I'd like to know where that... I found it! I found it! Look at it! It was under when I was showing you that very vanilla paper. I put it right on top of it. There's certain things that, I'm sorry, you just cannot go in. So here's this. Oh, I'm like going, now where's the, see, and look at this. Oh, so I'm going to try this an easy way and we'll see if that works. You like easy? Yeah. Why not? For me, when it comes to organization, it's one step forward, two steps back. Why am I putting that on there now before I wrap it around? I have no idea. But how do you clean the brushes? That's not in my wheelhouse, Barbara. That's a good question. You could do that. For me, what my plans are, I bought about... Either I have 6 or 9 over there. Okay, we're going to kind of see where this fits on here. So I know how high up to put it. And then I'm going to use them in color families. When you're done, hold on, let me put this on and then I'll finish that statement. Well, yeah, it would help if I put the other. Yeah, it's Friday. Thank you, Deb. You just brush them on a paper until no color comes off, right? And it doesn't take that long. And then the next time you use it, here, see, it looks like this, right? Let me go get a white piece of cardstock. Not that big. This will do. So I'm going to just rub this on here. See, there's not there very much on there. Okay. There's just a little bit. It's pretty much. It's pretty much clean. I mean, yeah, there's some on there, but let's pretend there's none on there. But look at it's not coming off on my hand. I'm going to go take this. I'm going to store it in a jar. And then I'm going to store it in a jar and then I'm going to go and call that good. Yeah. And then next time I come out, I'm going to use another color that is similar to that, you know, and so I'll have green ones. I'm going to have purple ones. I'm going to have red ones. I'm going to have yellow ones and I'll try not to cross pollinate. They say that you can, but I'm going to tell you these. Let me hold it up here. Hold on. These right here, those, see how many bristles there are? See how many? I mean, there's just a ton of them. That would take forever to dry. Just imagine if you had a lot of curly hair, thick curly hair. I mean, look how long it takes to dry. Well, imagine how that brush would take. You know, it's nice and soft and it's very dense. Yeah. Now, see, here's what Jamie says to use a microfiber towel and to wipe it on. And then that's really all you need to do. See? Yeah. But I would use light colors together. So now there's two ways that you can do this. You can go and put this on dimensionals all the way around, but I'm not going to do that. And those of you who know me know that I kind of like stuff to be attached all the way around. We're going to do both of these cards. We're going to have time for that because I got a prize at the end and I got a thing to think about. Yeah. You guys like that positive stuff, right? I like to put it just here. And you see, I've got it really, really close to the edge because I want that to grip. I don't want it to go in, you know. You just got to consider the force. It's trying to, the smarter thing might have been to go and put the glue on first, but you don't have to put tear and tape all the way around. I used to put tear and tape all the way around until one of my demonstrator friends schooled me. You know, that's a part of the power of being a demonstrator. You have ultimate, like, yeah, you have a ton of options. This is going to look nothing like the one that I got. The main thing is to remember is to don't go out. You can color outside the lines. You cannot glue in outside the lines. Got that? Yeah. I got that. Yeah. I like that. I like that a lot. Yes, I do. Now I'm going to try this. Some of this stuff, you know, I just haven't done it in a while. We're going to do like the same card. You could go and tie a bow, put a little knot on here, you know, or a little glue dot on here. That to me, it doesn't always work. I'm just going to do this. Let's see if my bunny bow works. I love this ribbon and I haven't used it, so it's very curly. Hold on. Back up, bud. I'll go put that on top of it and there it'll stop. Keep trying to figure out a way for me to show you how to do bows without, you know, with some close up. I've done some of my old recorded videos where I've shot two cameras at the same time where you can see close up, you know, how I do the bow close up and how I do the bow farther back. This is just a bunny bow, so it's not really stable, but you know, come on, I'm not stable. Look at no skunk. Yeah, all the main thing, I want it to be tight and I want it to be vertical, which right now that's horizontal, but it's vertical. Yeah. And do I do them both the same way? Do I cut them? These things I think about, but I don't want to come at the same time because I don't want them to layer together. See, I want one to be a little bit longer than the other. There you go. I think this will be a really nice card for Sympathy. Or maybe somebody broke up with their boyfriend. You know, we're celebrating 39 years and I think my husband's already picked out what we're going to do for our 40th anniversary. And I think we're going to try and buy a new car. This one that he's been looking at. Yep. I'll still keep mine. I like it. The way we've always done it. I get a new car and then he gets a new car. Okay, but to give you a hint, we keep cars at an average of 13 years. So it's a long time in between. His truck is a 2001. So, you know, yeah. Yeah, God love Toyotas. They last a long time. So see, I want that there. You could probably, if you wanted to spend a little bit more time on this, you could go, you know, I could do this on, oh, wait, you know, it's not too late. It's not too late. We'll just stamp it and see what it looks like real quick. Hold on. Just as a comparison. Do I have a small piece of it? No, I don't. Here's another thing. Because we covered this, wouldn't it be nice? So this, through Sunday, you can get this stamp set for free with a $50 order. Yes, sirree, Bob. Yeah, free with a $50 order. I'm not going to punch it. I'm not going to punch it out, right? But just so that you get, that's what I have, Laura. That's what I have. Yes, it's 5 years old now. Going on 6. So here, I think I would like it better like this. Don't you? What do you think? Crumb cake or very vanilla? This is awfully bright to me. And it's not too late to like pull that bad boy off because I'm going to be putting something on in the exact same place. I could sponge around the edge. I don't really want to because this is sponged. But now that you got me looking at it, I think, see, look at that, ripped a little bit. Oh, golly, my life is over. Oh, golly. Oh, yeah. I am just amazed. Okay, I'm just amazed at how my... cutting plates have not got, you know what? I don't even have to use this. I could use something else. They're really marked up, but they are not warped. You know, just proving my theory. That look at that. Ooh, there. No, try to get a really thin thing in the. I'm sorry, but I can't get it. You could tell, right? Now this is from the Tasteful. I think it's Tasteful Labels is what it's called. This is from Sweetly Stitched. And actually on this, I could have gone and wrapped it around here. Yeah, we're looking at a Highlander, but we want to have a... I think I like it like this, especially for a... sympathy card because it's more muted and stuff. And I could cut it on either side. There's no law saying that you can't cut it afterwards. But there, let's go back to that first one. And we're going to, this is the one, this is closer to the one that we originally made. And see, just by putting this pop of color behind here, see how that helps? Yeah. I think I'm going to do that. Okay, now don't be talking about my Fords. I drove a F-150 when I was in high school. It was great. It was my dad's business truck, and I can remember driving it a lot in my senior year. It was burnt orange and black. It was burnt orange and black, and it had 2 gas tanks, and since my dad, well, he owned the business, so he had his own gas pump, And so he would go and fill it up before he gave it to me on the weekend. Now, you could go a long way on 2 tanks of gas. I think at one point he was like, I'm not going to do both tanks. But he was pretty good about that. And he never noticed that I took out somebody's mailbox on a dark and stormy night. Yeah, he never noticed that. I didn't tell him what, before he died, you know. And then, yeah. However, my very first car was a Chevy Vega. It was brand new, and I put 2 short blocks in 35,000 miles. Oh, yeah. I used to drive my grandpa's Oldsmobile after he passed away. It was a 59. Ooh, I am dating myself. Yeah. I'm going to do the same thing here. But just look at how easy this card is to do and how someone would feel. Now, if you wanted to do this in all white, I would not use this ribbon, because this ribbon lends itself more to making it with crumb cake or Sahara sand. Sahara sand would be beautiful. But you might want to use, if you had like a shimmery ribbon, like this Blushing Bride, that would go well with white. The original card was done that way. Yeah, you know, so just be thinking about it. And these don't all have to be sympathy cards. That's just what I was going to do, because I have a couple that are late. Yeah, which reminds me, you know, I did talk to you about doing the 40 cards in 40 days. And if you're doing that, today would be day number 10. Oh my goodness, someone's calling me from the 88. Where's 880 area code? It better not be Utah. I don't want to turn it off, because what happens is then they know it's a real number. Nobody calls me on my cell phone. Unless, well, some of you who have gone to convention with me have it. That's different. But for the most part, I just take texts on my cell phone, because to me it's a little computer. I'm home 99% of the time. And if you ever email me or, you know, if you ever email me or something, I don't respond within 24 hours, there's something wrong. And so, you know, just find another way or send it again, because I almost did not see my invitation to get my second shot. How about that? And I know my husband didn't see his. They went and revamped the server, and all of a sudden, every single piece of junk mail goes through my, yeah, I see every single piece. It's not like it used to be. So, yeah, I put the tear and tape right next to the edge. This doesn't have to be so close to the edge, but the tear and tape should be close to the edge, not going over. We don't like... You know, exposed adhesive is against my religion. And so see, look at there. You don't really put very much on. You just spread it around. And then I've got the tear and tape right there along the edge so that holds it down. The thing is, though, is that I like to do these upside down so I can, because the main part that I think has to be right is the bottom, the top, and the right side. And if it's off on one side, no big deal. I mean, oh my goodness, the dog is snoring. The dog is snoring. Now this, you know, we can still, I think I'll just do a simple knot because of how big this is. I don't want to go in. See, if I just do it like this. Actually, hey, let's try tying it backwards. Then the tails will be up, but the knot will be backwards. Oh, I just love hanging out with you, because, you know, we all try different things. Oh. Yeah, this is a very stiff ribbon. Golly, where's the scissors? The scissors are right where I put them, where they were supposed to be. See, look at this one still, but I'm gonna encourage it to bend to my will. But what do you know? It kind of did. And how about this? If it doesn't, see, if I don't like the way that is, then I'm going to take a little bit of encouragement here. And we still got a prize left to go. So let me go in here. So for a, it's not so bad for a, we might go and put this on a smaller one again, but there, if I, and there's nothing saying this can't go off the side over. You don't want it to go off the side. You see pretty cards that look like that. Well, then they need a special envelope, and anything to save time, Stampin' Up! Makes really nice envelopes. Now, if I put that over the top like that, that gives a little bit more interest, but there you go. There you go. This would be nice with a really, a thicker one as well. But remember that you can not get this, the stamp set after Sunday. Heal your heart. We're in this together. I can't promise to always fix your problems, but I can promise you won't face them alone. Sorry for your loss. Don't know what I would do without you. Snap. That, and then thank you. So there you go. It's very easy. Very easy. So, okay, one thing I wanted to ask you, do you ever feel like this? Yeah. Do you ever feel like that? Yeah. That looks like a couple cats, I know. Yeah. Isn't that something? Do you ever feel like you're the canary that, no, are you the canary or are you the cat? You know, yeah. Are you the canary or are you the cat? So what I want you to do, just humor me here and go and close your eyes. Close your eyes. And even if you're not closing your eyes, then you're going to see this next thing. And then I want you to decide what you want. Right? Decide what you want. And then you can open your eyes, right? Decide what you want. You know, just think, what would be perfect for you in your, like in hobbies? Let's say we don't have to, you know, like, of course we'd all like to cure everything that's going around and make people a little bit more laid back in their life and stuff. And you would like, yeah, well, we can have a little bit of impact on that. And that's why we're doing the 40 cards in 40 days. But, you know, but what, you know, like your hobbies, would you like to improve on something? Would you like to, wow, I wish I knew how to do that fancy fold. Well, you know, decide what you want and then go get it. And you know what? I'm going to tell you where to get it. Yeah, I know these things. You need to join my team. Oh my goodness. I've got to tell you, you know, I can't promise how it's going to work out for everyone, but I can say that for me, it's been one of the best things I've ever done. Is life always perfect? No. But one of the best things I've done is get married to my husband. And the other one, well, and then have our daughter. And then after that, then, you know, become a demonstrator and start the team. Because, you know, doing these lives, I've met a lot of you. And then growing my team has been a great experience. And I appreciate all of you, whether you're a viewer or whether you're part of my team. But it's best if you're on my team. And right now you can get all this extra stuff for just $99. So what a great idea. Okay, you're going down the wrong road. Cabinets and countertops in her craft room. But you know what? I've got to tell you. If you join and then you get cabinets and countertops in your craft room, I'm not a tax professional, but you could be a tax write-off. Okay? Yeah. Oh, hey, I can help you with that, Chrissy. You have just given me the next thing about how I'm going to do something for the team. Yeah. Yeah. I can do a presentation on that. I've got, yeah, I don't take the best pictures, but they're pretty, yeah, you can see them, right? And hopefully they're not blurry. And if they are, I have to tell you that I'm sorry, but that dog is still looking like that. That is not a red light coming out of his rear end. That is actually the computer that runs this thing. So let's give away some coffee. Let's give away some coffee. I can also do it on Master Stamper because I know you're in that, Chrissy. You say, you know, yeah. Because I've been thinking about that, how to show people how to make it look like it blends into the backdrop. Yeah, we went and got, there they are. Look at in here. I think, no, that's just the envelope. Down at the bottom are the cards. So anyway, let's go and do that. I'm sorry for those of you who are over on YouTube and had an issue. You know, that's the thing about, okay, so this is 80. I'm going to say like 94. 94 is what it looks like. Yeah, you know, I can't guarantee. That's the thing about going live. Yeah. Gotta get my keyboard out. Oh, golly, look, I accidentally hit the button to give you a... No, I said 94. I bet you there's 96 there now. I'll bet you there are. Number 18. Oh, my goodness. I'm going to do it twice. So, yeah, you know, hey, if you've been thinking about doing it, do it now. Don't wait till Sunday. It'll be crazy on Sunday. I'm going to go and count these things. Oh, so Susan's in Virginia, I see. Oh, that's the wrong one. Okay. Oh, this is funny. This is funny. Here's number 18. Oh, Beverly, I already have to send you one. So now I get to send you two because I know you're still here. Brother is 76. Oh, wow. 6 years old and still races cars. I'm going to go to the other end too. Hold on. And you guys wonder, oh, hey, oh, there you go. Is Kathy DeLore still here? I hope so for her. It might. So let's see who's still here. Yeah, I finally got the right one on there. But you both have to say something because otherwise I might forget. And you know, you have to go and shoot me an email with your mailing address so I don't have to look it up. I'm just trying to find the right button here. Oh, yes. Okay. So. Woo. Whoop, wrong one. I hit the wrong. Yeah, I'm hitting the wrong button. I'm just. Here we go. That's the button I want.
Winner.
And then here is the other one. They're both here. So yeah, just go and email me your address so that I don't have to look it up. You'd be surprised. It's just a little thing for you, but it saves me a lot of, because some names are here, some names are there, and then I have to think, and it just kind of puts a spanner in the works, and I can just go and copy and change, and yeah, don't forget to change it for Monday. Yeah. Oh, I might be doing my code a little bit different so that you don't have to remember codes. Yeah. Anything for you, my friend. You know, make this the worst thing that happened to you today. It's go red for ribbon. No, go red for women. Go out and take a 15-minute walk. Walk to the mailbox. Walk to the end of the block. I don't care if you have to put snow boots on. Just go out there, just 15 minutes and walk back and just refresh yourself. I'm going to do it. And then I'm going to go and start making cards to mail them out and bless somebody today. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun into your day. Hey, I'll see you Monday, 1 o'clock.